Third Sunday morning here at Grace Chapel, AME Church, oh Heavenly Father. Yes, yes. We thank you, Lord, for we woke up this morning, closing our right minds, yes, yes. Oh Heavenly Father, and being able to say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you this morning, oh the Lord, for letting us come and see another day, dear Lord.
Yes.
Oh Heavenly Father, but most of all, we thank you for letting us have a church going mind.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. A church going mind, we'll come out and praise your holy name.
Yes.
Thank you, O Heavenly Father, for life being well with us, O Heavenly Father. Thank you, dear Lord, for all of our lives. Thank you for each one here on the sound of my voice. And dear Lord, thank you for the ones that are on their way to church this morning, dear Lord. Thank you, O Heavenly Father, let them get here safe, dear Lord. And then, Lord, we know that thou, God, beside thee, there is no other. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for all things. The high mountains, the low valleys, the deep blue seas, O Heavenly Father. We thank you for everything. But, O Heavenly Father, most of all, we thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ. Who came over 2,000 years ago, Heavenly Father, healing the sick, raising the dead, and giving sight to the blind. Oh, we thank you for Jesus this morning, O Heavenly Father. Oh, Heavenly Father, we thank you, dear Lord, and ask that you go with us as we visit the sick and the shedding. As we visit the prisons, oh Heavenly Father, the jailhouses, dear Lord. Go with us, oh Heavenly Father, as we continue to stay on this Christian journey. Oh Heavenly Father, oh Heavenly Father, thank you this morning. Thank you for everything, oh Heavenly Father. And again, Lord, thank you for keeping us safe on the dangerous highway. Oh Heavenly Father, thank you for everything. And then, Lord, we want to thank you for the soldiers on the battlefield. Let them know, Heavenly Father, that someone may find you this morning. Let them know that you are God and beside thee there is no other. Heavenly Father, take care of the leaders of the world. Heavenly Father, take care of each one. And then, Lord, I ask you to pray, and we pray for our preacher this morning, God. We pray to the pastor of this great church, Lord. Continue letting him preach what thus said the Lord. Oh, Heavenly Father, we thank you for him and his family. Be with him and stand by. Dear Lord, and all his staff. And, and we thank you, oh Heavenly Father. For Brother Hill and Sister Hill, oh Heavenly Father. Oh, Heavenly Father, we just thank you for their family. And then, Lord, we thank you, Lord, for each member here. Pray for them one by one. Be with the leadership of this community and this church, oh Heavenly Father. Help them continue to do what thou sayest, Lord. Oh, Heavenly Father, we thank you for everything. And then, Lord, a time will come. Our hymn books and our Bibles. Instead of wanting more, Heavenly Father. We don't know where we may be on the dangerous highways, on our bed of affliction. Wherever we may be, oh Heavenly Father, we ask that thou be with us. Oh Heavenly Father, when we gird across that old Jordan River. Dear Lord, let it be to come. Father, we can come into your glory and just be with you, oh Heavenly Father. We ask that you bless this morning. In the saving name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Thank you for that one in prayer, brother.
Glory, glory.
Down.
just a leg of old burden down. Amen, amen, amen. We want to thank each and every one joining our devotion service early this morning. Now, in the turn in the hands of Sister Father, praise God.
Good morning.
Good morning.
May we all stand for the intro to worship.
Amen.
preaching by Brother Marvin Carr.
Amen.
Before I start praying, I really want to ask each and every one of us in here this one little question. Do we know? Do we know how we got here this very day, right now, right at this time? Our Heavenly Father, do we know? I got up this morning, and when I got up this morning, I asked myself, do I know? I came to a week. At the end of another week, I started a week, I came through a week, and I asked myself, do I know how I got here this morning? Do I know all the blessings that I got this day? Do I understand that there is a God? And the God that I'm talking about is the God that brought us to this very point, who gave us air to breathe every day, who gave us the nostrils to breathe the air in. How important is your name? Thank you, our Heavenly Father. Thank you for every blessing that you gave. Thank you, our Heavenly Father, that when I got up this morning, I opened my eyes and there was something that I could see. And that was blessings that you have gave to us all week long. Thank you, our Heavenly Father, that we did nothing on our own, that we didn't get up on our own. Thank you, our Heavenly Father, for being able to know that there is a God, and a God who's in control of all things. He's in control of our every life, every function that we have, he's in control of it. Every blessing that we get,
amen.
Every blessing that he gave the Maddox, every blessing that he gave to the Reeds, every blessing that he gave to the Paul, he gave to us through love. We didn't earn a thing. We didn't earn not one thing that we earned, but you gave it to us out of your love. You told us that you would provide for us. You've been a provider. This week you were one of the best providers because we stand here today. We stand here today. We came to church today. And it was all because of you. Nothing we do is because of us. And our Heavenly Father, we give you thanks each and every day. Thank you for waking us up. Thank you for the jobs you gave us. Thank you for our spouses. Thank you for this church. Thank you for the pastor of this church. Thank you for the members of this church. Everybody in this church makes up Grace Chapel. And Grace Chapel is a turning point for all of our lives. We started one way. We came in one way. And when we leave here today, we're going out a different way. We're not going in the same. We're not going out the same way we came in. I came in with stuff on my mind. But when I leave here, I'm going to be relieved. Thank you, our Heavenly Father, for everybody that came between these doors. Know that there is a reward today. And the reward that we're going to receive is going to be the word from on high. Brought to you by the man that you placed in this church. To lead us, to guide us. As we join in this church today, looking for a word, hoping that the word that we get will help us through next week. Knowing that when we make it through next week, it still will be only because of you. Through your grace and through your mercy. There are some people that didn't make it to this day. We have people right now that's in their bed of affliction, knowing that God, that they are waiting on you. They're waiting on you to make a change in their life. Whether it's going to be for you to heal them, or whether it's going to be the other way around, but we accept your will. Thank you, our Heavenly Father, for having a will and a plan for us. Because we don't have a plan for ourselves. And although we get up each and every day, some days we may not say thank you. But God, we know. We know that we didn't get up on our own. Thank you for life being as well as it is for us. Thank you for all the blessings. I could stand here all day long. And I'm still going to leave out a blessing that you gave. And God, for that I say I'm sorry. I ask if you'll take my heart. Take my heart. Take the things that I stand for. Change the things that's not right. And replace them with your love. But teach us.
Teach us.
Teach us how to love and respect each other.
Yes.
Teach us how to genuinely say, I'm sorry. How to genuinely say, I love you. And mean it from the depths of our heart.
Yes.
Thank you, our Heavenly Father, because every emotion is the emotion that you gave.
Yes.
Whether it's love, hate, or whatever, we have to learn to control it.
Yes.
And if we come to church, we will learn to control
it. Yes, sir.
I pray for everybody who's on a sick bed.
Yes.
I pray for those who's in nursery homes.
Yes, Lord.
I pray for comfort for all the people who are struggling with so many different things, knowing that we all have something we got to overcome. Yes. We all have a struggle each and every day. And as we walk this life,
yes.
God, we ask if you'll continue to be the head of our life.
Please,
and to help us every step along the way. Help us to change everything that's not right.
Help us, Lord.
God, help us to look inside our own soul.
Yes.
Before we ever point a finger at somebody else, change us first.
Change,
help us through your word, through your love.
Yes.
And God, I ask that you will continue to walk inside each and every church, to be inside each and every heart in this church. So when you open up our heart,
yes, sir,
you cleanse it as well.
Yes.
God, these and all things I ask in your Son Jesus Christ's name, I continue to pray. Amen.
Amen.
We are friends, O Lord.
Lord at all times. His praise shall continuously be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast. In the Lord, the humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name together. For the word of God and the people.
Thanks be to God. May we all stand for the preface to the death law from all that dwell. You shall have no other gods before me.
Lord.
Unto it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Glory be to the Father.
Taylor stood up and asked the church for prayers that she was going to be entering into the homecoming court. Well, guess what? She won this freshman. And now I'm going to turn the program over to Jocelyn Hill.
Amen.
Come on, saints, let's give the Lord some praise in the house today. Be praised. Giving out to God who's ahead of my life, to my pastor, Pastor Stembridge, my first lady, my father, Reverend Hill, and everybody. We come now to the part where we're highlighting our Black History moment. How many know about back in the day? I know a lot of y'all know about back in the day. Yes, I was born in 1974, so I didn't get a chance to be in cotton fields and all that, but I read about it and I know about it. Sometimes you can see the struggle. You see it on some of the people, and you can hear them talk. And a lot of times, you know, back in the day, old people would come up and tell you, you know, you had to say, learn to say, yes, ma'am, no, ma'am, no, sir, yes, sir. And it was the way you were taught and the way you were trained. And I just wanted to share one little Black history moment. Back in the day, you know, our family was like soul food on Sundays. After church, you go down Grandmama's house to eat.
And we used to call that down to the house. And they bring, grandma and them always brought the preacher home with them after church, because they had to feed the preacher. And there were so many of us cousins, and mind you, it was like 14 brothers and sisters of my mom and them. And as children, we had to wait to eat until the preacher had come to eat. Yes, we were mad, we were upset, but we had to wait to eat. Wondering how long is it going, if he just hurry up and drank that sweet tea. I'm so hungry. But we had to learn to wait. And once we got to the table, we had to be very memorable. We just had to say our graces. And we had to make sure we eat. And the main important thing, you had to learn to eat those vegetables whether you wanted them or not. Because the first thing they'll tell you, you hungry? You ain't gonna eat them, but you ain't gonna eat nothing at all. So those are some of the moments that I can remember coming up. And I'm here right now to introduce my nephew, who's gonna be coming. His name is O'Neal, well, Sydney O'Neal Hill. I call him June. That's my nephew. And he's gonna be doing the I Have a Dream speech. He's a 16-year-old in Eastside High School. He's very, very talented. He plays the saxophone, of course, y'all heard that. He can also play the piano, and he can sing like his daddy. So, very talented young man. And before he comes, I also want to do one more thing. I want to do this song, and I want y'all to sing with, but you know, back in the day, they didn't have no music. So we're gonna do this without no music. All thing they had was hand clapping and foot stomping. Now I want you to add a little drums for me, young man, because that's gonna signify some of the foot stomping. Those of y'all have arthritis and don't want to use foot. Okay? Y'all ready? I want y'all come on and stand up and help me sing this song. But he's a better lad in the time.
Demonstration for freedom in the history of our nation. Amen. 50 years ago, a great American in whose symbolic shadow we stand today signed the Emancipation Proclamation. This momentous decree came as a great beacon light of hope to millions of Negro slaves who had been seared in the flames of withering injustice. It came as a joyous daybreak to end the long nights of their captivity. But 100 years later, the life of the Negro still is not free. But 100 years later, the life of the Negro is still sadly crippled by the manacles of segregation and by the chains of discrimination. 100 years later, the Negro lives on a lonely island of poverty in the midst of a vast ocean of material prosperity. 100 years later, the Negro is still languishing in the corner of American society and finds himself in exile in his own land. All right. So we have come here today to dramatize an appalling condition. In a sense, we have come to our nation's capital to cash a check. When the architects of our republic wrote the magnificent words of the Constitution and the Declaration of Independence, they were signing a promissory note to which every American was to fall heir. This note was a promise that all men would be guaranteed the inalienable rights of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. I am not unmindful that America has defaulted on this promissory note, insofar as her citizens of color are concerned. Instead of honoring the sacred obligation, America has given the Negro people a bad check, a check which has come back marked insufficient funds. But we refuse to believe that the Bank of Justice has gone bankrupt. We refuse to believe that there are insufficient funds flowing in the great vaults of opportunity of this nation. So we have come here today to cash that check, a check that will give us the pawn demand, the riches of freedom, and the security of justice. I am not unmindful that some of you have come from great trials and tribulations. Some of you have come from fresh, narrow cells. Some of you have come from areas where your quest for freedom has left you staggered by the storms of persecution and battered by the winds of police brutality. You have been the veterans of creative suffering, so continue to work with the faith that unearned suffering is redemptive. Go back to Mississippi. Go back to Alabama. Right. Go back to Louisiana. Go back to Georgia. Yes. Go back to the slums and ghettos of our northern cities, knowing that somehow this situation can and will be changed. Yeah. Let us not wallow into the valley of despair, I say to you today, my friends. And even though we face the difficulties and frustrations of the moment, I still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted into the American dream. I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident and that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at a table of brotherhood. I have a dream that one day even the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering with the heat of injustice, sweltering with the heat of oppression, will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. Mm-hmm. I have a dream that one day my four children will be able to live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character.
Yes.
I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day even the state of Alabama, a state whose governor's lips are presently dripping with the words of interposition and nullification, will be transformed into a situation where little black boys and black girls will be able to hold hands with little white boys and white girls and walk together as sister and brother. I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day every valley shall be exalted, every hill and mountain shall be made low, all the rough places shall be made plain, and the crooked shall be made straight, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. This is our hope. This is the faith in which I return to the South with. With this faith, we will be able to hew out the mountains of despair, a stone of hope. With this faith, we will be able to transform the jangling discourse of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood. With this faith, we will be able to work together, to pray together, to struggle together, to go to jail together, to stand up and fight for freedom together, knowing that somehow this situation can and will be changed. This is the day when all of God's children will be able to sing with a new meaning. My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing. Lands where my father died, land of the pilgrim's pride, from every mountainside, let freedom ring. And if America's to become a great nation, then this must become true. So let freedom ring from the prodigious hilltops of New Hampshire. Let freedom ring from the mighty mountains of New York. Let freedom ring from the heightening Alleghenies of Pennsylvania. Let freedom ring from the curvaceous slopes of Colorado. Let freedom ring from the snow-capped Rockies of California. But not only that, let freedom ring from Lookout Mountains of Tennessee. Let freedom ring from Stone Mountain of Georgia. Let freedom ring from every hill and mole hill of Mississippi. From every mountainside, let freedom ring. And when we allow this to happen, when we allow it to ring from every village, from every state, from every hamlet to every city, we'll be able to speed up that day when all of God's children, black man, white man, Jews, Gentiles, Protestants, and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing the words of the old Negro spiritual. Free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
Oh,
now we will have a selection by the Hill family.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
To talk about dreams and visions. In Matthew 6 and 3, he says, "But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you." Romans 12 and 12 states, "Rejoicing in hope, patient in tribulation, continue instant in prayer." Also, John 1, 2 and 27 states, "But the anointing which ye have received on him abideth in you, and ye need not that any man teach you, but as the same anointing teach you in all things, and it is true, and it is no lie. And even as it has taught you, ye shall abide in him." Acts 3 and 17, "And it shall come to pass in the last days, said God, I will pour out all my spirit upon all flesh. All right. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. And your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams." Daniel 1 and 17, "As for these four children, God gave them knowledge and skill in all learning and wisdom. And Daniel had understanding in all visions and dreams." Hebrews 10 and 34, "Cast not away therefore your confidence, which have great recompense of reward." Job 33, 11, 17, "He put my feet in the stocks, he marked all my path." James 1 and 15, "If any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God, that giveth to all men liberally and upbraideth not, and it shall be given him. Luke 1 and 37, for with God nothing shall be impossible. Proverbs 29 and 18, where there is no vision, the people perish. But he that keepeth the law, happy he is. That is one educator that I like to highlight about vision of dreams, and that was Benjamin E. Mays. Dr. Benjamin E. Mays was a giant in the Christian ministry in American education. He is remembered for his outstanding leadership and service as a teacher, preacher, mentor, scholar, author, and activist in the civil rights movement. And I want to leave with you these words that Dr. Benjamin Mays stated. It must be borne in mind that the tragedy of life doesn't lie in not reaching your goal. The tragedy lies in having no goals to reach. It isn't a calamity to die with dreams unfulfilled, but it is a calamity to not to dream. It is not a disaster to be unable to capture your ideal, but it is a disaster to have no ideal to capture. It is not a disgrace not to reach the stars, but it is a disgrace to have no stars to reach. Mm. Not failure, but low aim is sin. Mm. May we pray. Oh, Father God, I know that you stay in your word. For you know the plans that we have, that you have toward us, said the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. Amen.
Amen.
Today, I want to let you all know how good my God is. On Monday, I was laying there taking a nap and my cell phone kept going off. Normally, I don't answer my phone if I'm asleep. So my phone kept going off, kept going off, kept going off. So I woke up, I said, let me see who this is that keep texting me. And it was Courtney. And she said, Mama, my kids don't call me Mama, they call me Mommy. She said, there are tornadoes down, touching down around us. Can you please pray for me? When I took her there in August, I was pissed off because they had put my child in the basement of the dorm. That's where her room is. So I got on the phone. I called four people. First, I called God. Second, I called my mama. I called Reverend Miss Stembridge. I called Reverend Miss Hill. I said, I need for you all to pray for me. Tornadoes are touching down in Alabama, around Tuskegee University. Can you please pray that God will cover my child? I said, I cannot do it by myself. So for that, I'm telling y'all, thank you for your prayers and continue to pray. Amen. Because you never know what God is telling you.
Yes.
I thank God that God put my child in that basement of that door. That's the safest place that she can be. He knew what he was doing, but I didn't know what he was doing. So for that, I said thank you.
He knows.
Yes, he does. Continue to pray for her.
Amen.
And pray for me.
Thank you.
And as you all come, I ask you to continue to pray for each other. Pray for our sick and shut in. Pray for our youth.
Yes.
And as the Reverend Stembridge come today, put him behind the cross, God out in front, so that he can give us the message that we need to go and tell others. Please come.
Oh,
He allowed us to come together one more time. One more time, one more time, one more time. He allowed us to pray together one more time. Our Father, most gracious Father, which art in heaven, our Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior, I just said thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, for your Son, Jesus Christ, that you didn't have to send him down here when that was many mansions up there, but you allowed your only begotten Son to come down here on this old shameful world to teach your word, to raise the dead, to make the blind to see, to make the lame to walk, to clear the lepers, and fed the 5,000. Thank you, Lord, for your Son, Jesus the Christ. Father God, as I come here today, Father God, thinking about Sister Father, daughter, that's my second child anyway. She's all our child. Because my daughter's in college also. And we just give praise because we don't know what God got in store for us or our children. But Father God, all we have to do is just trust in you, Father. Yes. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior. And we know everything is going to be all right. I read a segment early this morning to keep on going. That's what it said, because sometimes you get weary of life and sometimes you just don't want to go no farther. But when I read this segment, it said, in the mountains, there's a lot of fog.
Yes, sir.
And when that fog, that's through our trials and our tribulations that we're going through. That's that fog. But as Brother Sappho said, there's a bright a day ahead.
Yes, it is.
And as we go through that fog, that sunshine is definitely going to shine.
Yes.
So as we go on up that road 3 or 4 more miles or 10 miles or 20 miles, there's going to be that sunshine. Sometimes God allowed us to go through that fog to make us what we are today, to make us stronger today, to give us that knowledge, that wisdom, the understanding that he wants us to have. Because it's all about him and not about us. I'm talking about Jesus Christ. We go through those trials and tribulations, God sometimes pulls us through it to make us stronger, to allow us to be stronger in his word, to allow us to go forth in his word. Thank you, Lord, for going through those trials and tribulations, because you made me stronger. When I was in that fog, when I couldn't see that forest for the trees, then you allowed that path to see the light. When that road was crooked, I couldn't see it, but somebody was praying for me. My grandmother, my mom, my dad, my sibling was praying for me.
Well, well. Yes, sir.
I just want to thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
For everything you've done and continue to do in our life. Because, Father God, we don't know what that past going to bring. But, Lord, you know everything. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
For being my guidance. For looking over me when I couldn't look over myself. Somebody in this church might need you for one thing, Lord, and somebody might need you for something else, Lord. But Lord, you know all our needs. Father God, you know every hair of our body, Father. Father God, in this walk of Christian life, it's not easy, Father God, but we can make it easy.
Yes, sir.
Father God, that young man that got up there, and I thought he had a paper in front of him, Father God, but Father God, that was wisdom and knowledge that you gave him. your arms around him and his family. Because that I had a dream was something else. Father God, I told my young brother that God is watching over him and protecting him. Because he are our children. He might not be biological children, but he are the children of this church. And to keep on going through those trials and tribulations, and he might be a president or anything. We don't know. But God knows everything. Yes. And just keep on watching over him and his family, and the Hills family. Not only the Hill family, but all the families here in this church today. At the sound of my weak voice. I was so proud of my daughter last night when she won the freshman homecoming queen. That I didn't know anything about it. I told her I was there to support her. Yes. The basketball game, it mean a lot, but it didn't mean nothing to me. I was there for Taylor. And by me being there, it made me feel good when they said, you won the freshman homecoming queen. Yes. Amen. Yes. And it was God. That's all it was. It was God. Because yes. God, yes. God put you in those past and the future that we don't know anything about, but God knows everything. Yes. So just keep on blessing our children. Yes. Keep on blessing us, Lord. As we go through our trial, tribulation, amen. Father God, we know you're a doctor in the sick room. Uh-huh. We know you're a lawyer in the courtroom. Yeah. And Father God, when we don't have any friends, we know that you can be our friend. Yeah. And Father God, on the battlefield of those soldiers that fight on for the war that we don't know anything about. But Father God, thou knows everything. Wow. Keep on blessing them and their family also. And keep on blessing our president of the United States. President Obama.
Yes, yes.
And our pastor of this church.
Well.
The leaders of this church.
Yes.
The pastors of Church University all over the land of not a separate prayer. Well. The leaders all over the land of the universe also.
Yes, Lord.
And we just gonna keep on praising your name, Lord. Uh-huh. Hallelujah to your name. I ask all they blessed in Jesus' name. Amen, amen.
Amen. Amen.
At this time, we will have a selection by the choir, and after the selection, we will hear from our very own Reverend Charlie Frank Stembridge Sr.
Where I belong.
Time today. Praising our Lord one more time. The last song said, "Search me, Lord." Yeah. Are you scared to tell me, ask me to search you? If you know you're doing what you can, the best you can, you don't mind it. But now I leave it alone. When you're bad, when the police pull you over. First thing they want to do is search you in the car.
Yeah.
But if you don't have anything wrong, you don't mind, they say, here you are, go ahead. But you got to be kind of high, you might get to shaking a little bit.
Yeah.
Thank you, Brother Reed and Quiet, for that song and all the songs. And we had a wonderful time here today.
Yeah.
And little Cindy come here and stood here boldly. Made his speech and I heard all the singing, and so now it's preach time.
Amen.
Y'all say amen, I won't hold you too long.
Amen.
Might be just a little long, but if you say amen, I'll try to show it.
Amen.
But I don't know what the Lord want me to do about showing
it. Amen.
Preach.
Reverend Hill, we're always glad to see you here. And while the hill was doing all that, I said I should have just sat down today and let it been here today.
Yes, sir. Amen.
And you know he can't rest. He might as well get some together, so I'll be calling him again pretty soon.
All right.
So we on the same bandwagon trying to get to the same place.
Yes, sir.
Amen. I want to dedicate this sermon today to bless Cindy and all of you in here today. And I thought about my two or three in college and others, dedicated them as well.
Amen.
You had your Bible today. The book of Joshua, you'll find our message.
All right.
In the book of Joshua, you find our message. Mm-hmm. Message kind of sum around with Black History Month.
Amen.
And we thought preaching, you might say, well, this might be for me, it might be for me.
Amen.
It's all good. It's just a good sermon that we need to listen to the word of the Lord.
Amen.
I'm sending you another little sermon. The book of Joshua, the third chapter, the first chapter began at the third verse.
All right.
You'll find these readings. The Lord want to bless the Israelites and do what he says, Brother Reverend Hill.
All right.
Joshua, the first chapter, again, at the third verse.
All right.
He told Joshua and the Israelites that every place that the sole of your feet shall tread upon,
yeah,
that have I given unto you, as I said unto Moses.
All right.
Should I be sounding pretty good, Brother Matty?
Yes, sir.
Every place the sole of your feet thread of on, I give it to you. Folks, he went on to them how far? From the wilderness in this Lebanon, even to the great river, the great Euphrates, all the lands of the Hittites, unto the great sea toward the going down of the sun, shall be your coast. There shall not any man be able to stand before thee all the days of thy life. When you give yourself to the Lord.
Yes, sir.
He said, as I was with Moses, so I will be with thee.
Yes, sir.
I like this part. I will not fail thee, nor forsake thee.
Yes, sir.
Don't be scared, he said.
Yes, sir.
Don't be weak.
Right.
Sixth verse said, be strong and good courage.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
For unto the people shall thou divide for an inheritor of the land. God put his foot down when he said, which I swear to that father to give them. I want you to have it.
Yes, sir.
Trying to give it to you.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
You don't have to turn, but the 6th chapter of Joshua, in the 1st and 7th verse, you'll find these readings. God told him, Brother Matt, in the 1st chapter, I want to give it to you.
Yes, sir. Yes.
But the 6th chapter, 1st and 7th verse, you'll find these readings.
Go ahead, Pastor.
And they were going to get it, Sister Paul. The 1st verse says, now Jericho was straightly shut up because of the children of Israel. None went out, and none came in. And the Lord said to Joshua, see, I have given to thy hand Jericho, though big king, and the mighty men of battle. I want you to have it.
Yes, sir.
I'm going to give it to you. And they were going to get it.
Yes, sir. Yes, yes.
But the 6th chapter in the 1st verse said, now Jericho was straightly shut up because of the children of Israel.
Yes, sir.
Didn't want them to go through their city. Want to talk for a little while today. Don't let something block your blessing.
All right. Go ahead, right. Yes, sir.
Don't let something block your blessing.
Yes, sir.
And when you saw them big king and the soldier, they got scared. But I want to tell you the 2nd part. Don't let nobody turn you around.
Yes, sir. Amen.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Don't let nobody or something block your blessing.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And don't let nobody turn you around.
Yes, sir. Amen. Amen.
Sister Paul, Sister Will, my wishes, we all want a blessing. We're all hoping and dreaming of a blessing. But I want to tell you today that many people have had many blessings already waiting for them. But many people, or those same people, have missed most all of their blessings.
Yes, sir.
The reason why they miss it is because every time they go to get their blessing, they always find something in the way. Okay. Something always was standing in the way, Brother Walker, to keep them from getting their blessing.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Instead of going on or standing there, see how to figure out how to get around it, many of them just gave up and went back or turned around and went back the other way. Uh-huh. But I stopped by to tell you today that whenever God have a blessing for you, or whenever somebody else have a blessing for you, and when you want to get your blessing, don't let nothing stop you from getting your blessing.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. All
right. Many times we let people turn us around from getting our blessing. I don't know about you, but when I feel it in my heart that God has something waiting for me, I'm not going to let nobody at this thing, this song, turn me around. And this is how it is today in our text here today in our sermon. We find that today come from the book of Joshua, the 1st and the 6th chapter. In the 1st chapter, we find it coming from the 3rd to the 6th verse. In the 6th chapter, it comes from the 1st verse and the 2nd verse. When we look at these two verses here, we find that God was getting ready to bless the children of Israel.
Yes, right.
He was getting ready to give Joshua and his people something. Uh-huh. And I looked at Sister Brown and I said, who is these people?
Well,
when I looked at it, they were the Israelites.
Yes, sir.
But they were the young Israelites. Uh-huh. The old crowd had died out in the wilderness.
Yes, sir.
And God was getting ready to give them their blessing.
Yes, sir.
And how was and what were their blessing? Mm-hmm. Did you look at Joshua the 3rd chapter? He told them what their blessing was.
All right.
He said, now when you go over there, Jordan, everywhere your foot shall stand on the ground, therefore, I'm going to give you for your blessing.
Amen.
I'm going to give you a plague and called your own home.
Yes, sir.
Look at the Israelites here. They were this special group that God called their special kind of people. God loved them. They were God's special folks. Ain't it good that you can just sit here and feel that you're doing what's right, that God will call you his special? This little group here was special to God. But you look around in history, there were many other big powerful nations during that time. But look what had happened to the Israelites. The Israelites had gone down in Egypt, and it looked like there were laws that had been forgotten by everybody. But you feel like that sometimes. Feel like everybody then forgot you and put you down. Seems like that would happen then, but look what God did to the children of Israel. God called them out, and God formed them and shaped them to a nation. And then, Brother Matty, when God called in their nation, they were the smaller and they were the weakest of all other nations. And all them other nations were just strutting around the little children of Israel. But look what God did. God called them out and God taught them and said, if you obey me and follow me, I'll take care of you. And then God followed God and God listened to God, and God began to teach them. They began then to feel a little better. God called Moses and said, now go down and lead them and teach them and do what I asked you to do for them. Moses obeyed God. Moses went like somebody when God tell her we want to think about it for a while. Moses went down in Egypt, but Kennedy led them out of Egypt, led them to the wilderness. When Moses led them out, Moses was just done his job. But then everybody want to know about who are the Israelites. The great story of the Israelites started and began when some of Abraham's descendants decided they go down in Egypt to find some food. They went down as free folks. Didn't nobody put no handcuffs and took them down. But when they went down there, they were free. But while they were down there for a crime, they found themselves some being put in slavery, put in bondage under that tough king called Pharaoh. But while they were there in bondage, something happened. God lent them something. They learned how to pray. I want you to talk to me just a little while today. But it's all right. I just preach it anyhow. While they were down there in bondage, that's when they learned how to pray. But God said, we had to begin to pray, cry to God. God told Moses, go down there and lead my men, my children, out of the land of Egypt. Moses wants you to lead them to the home place, a place called the promised land. There were their blessings going to be waiting over there in the promised land. And I like Moses. He did what God told him. He led them to the promised land. But when he got there, Moses found out that God had already told him, you can't go no further. But Moses did what God had told him to do. If everybody would do what God tell us to do, someone won't. Our crown now, but do what God said. Do God will take care of you later on. Moses, brother Charles, led them to the promised land. And then there in Deuteronomy, the 31st chapter, God called Moses and Joshua and said, come up here to me. Moses, this boy is born. Now Joshua is taking over. Now here in our 6th chapter, Joshua, we find that Joshua now is taking over. While they're sitting out there by the banks, they didn't know which way to go, but the Spirit of God moved and said, Joshua, get up and take them over. I got a blessing waiting for them. Reverend Hill, after they've been sitting there for a while, twisting and niching and going on and anxious and want to go, they decided to get up there with the joy to start toward the promised land. But after they got ready to go, they found out that there was something standing in their way. But I stopped by got your mind made up.
Yeah.
Don't let nothing or don't let something block you from your blessing. Let us slow it down a little bit. This is what we call Black History Month. Uh-huh. And here we are talking about don't let nobody turn you around.
All right.
I believe in my heart that when I look back in years past, that God blessed the blacks and others back then just like he did the Israelites.
Uh-huh.
I guess I better say that again.
Go ahead, Say it.
Some of y'all probably missed that.
Uh-huh.
I still believe that way back then.
Uh-huh.
That God blessed the blacks and others.
Yes, sir.
Just like it did the Israelites back in their day.
Yes, sir.
You heard me say it, God bless others.
Yes.
God didn't just bless the black folks. But God bless whoever want to be blessed.
Yes.
But by this Black History Week, then look at how Brother Matty blessed and brought the black people to where we are today.
That's right.
When we look at this black race, some people had compared and said, you know that the black race, our history, we can compare just like the Israelites.
Yes, sir.
Well,
I thought about that.
Go ahead,
Pastor. Out of all of the other races, how can we be compared to the only one just like the Israelites? Then I figured out what they were saying.
Yeah.
When the Israelites went down in Egypt, they went down free.
Yes, sir.
But while they were down in a strange land, they wound up, so to read, being put in prison.
Yes, sir.
Being put down there in slavery.
Yeah, right.
And then when you look at us, when we came over here, we also will come to a strange land, but we end up just like the Israelites, we too put in slavery.
Yes, sir.
But then the black did just like the Israelites.
Uh-huh.
Even though they were there down the slave, the Israelites knew how to call on God.
Yeah.
They showed up, knew how to pray.
Yeah.
Let me tell you how God do this thing.
Go ahead.
A lot of time when everything is smooth, y'all, got to be a half caught up.
Yes, sir.
Wife and husband getting along pretty good.
Yes, sir.
Children not worrying, not bothering you too much.
Amen.
We're too easy then, Brother Kenneth, to go to home and try to watch the late news as long as we can and hurry up and say a quick prayer and jump in the bed.
Yes, sir.
You ain't prayed like that. You just went through the most.
Amen.
Every now and then, God know how to make a prayer.
Yes, sir.
If you don't believe that, act trigger the Father.
Amen.
After when that hurricane was coming, the tornado coming out through Alabama. That was called prayer.
Yeah.
My call mama. My call preaching to others, all of us gonna pray.
Yes.
When we always pray, says this prayer to God, he heals.
Yes.
I pray.
Yeah.
It was like they went in there and eat, they were doing like some of us today.
Yeah.
Maybe God ain't got your life, but when you put him in prison, my Bible tells me in Exodus, the second chapter, around the 27th verse, they thought praying so hard until the cry heard up, and God heard them way up in heaven.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Heard the pain, he felt the pain through their prayer.
Yes.
Yes.
Then when he sent Moses other down there and said, go down there and bring my children out.
Yes, sir.
But you know that our ancestors did the same thing?
Yes.
They had something to pray for.
Yes, sir.
They knew how to pray.
Yes.
Here we are now, we trying to pray, but we living in luxury, luxury, luxury.
Yes.
Here they were going to bed with a hole in the pants.
Amen.
Shoes run over.
Yes, sir.
They hadn't had a good bath in a few days, but they knew how to pray.
Yes, sir.
So God, we ain't worried about ourselves, but help us to make it easier for our children.
Yes, sir.
I believe God did them just like he did the Israelites.
Uh-huh.
When they got ready to set them free down here in the south, we were all over the south, just like the Israelites were all over Egypt. They were everywhere, but when they set us free, I can hear God saying, go.
Uh-huh. Right. Yes,
wherever you go, when you go up north, out west, down south, or just go from where you are, I got a blessing waiting for you.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Can't you think it's Lord sang that song then, I'm finna go, I'm going over yonder, but when they got there, got started, they found out something, this Stembridge was in better ways.
Yes, sir. Amen.
Keep them from getting their blessings.
Yes, sir. Amen.
But I about to tell you today when God got a blessing for you. Don't let something block your blessing.
Yes.
When God got a blessing for you,
yes.
Don't let nobody turn you around.
Yes.
Have a look at how I take you today for a little while. I don't want to hold you too long.
Uh-huh. Yes, sir.
The Lord had set the Israelites free.
Yes,
sir.
Joshua 1:3 said, the Lord told us that now y'all free.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Everywhere you go, that land gonna be yours.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Can't see the other light after this young crowd, old crowd had died out.
Yeah.
More of them had died out in the wilderness.
Yeah.
But can't you see the young crowd here sitting by the bank saying, let's get up and go over to the other side. They start packing up, bro, walk, combing their hair, and getting ready to say, get all the baby and everything. We going over to the promised land.
Yeah.
We're going over to get our gift that God got for us.
Yeah.
But old Miss Stembridge, that's him, when they got ready to go, went over that muddy joint when Brother Mattis prayed his prayer, said, let it be a calm time.
Yeah.
But Brother Mattis, I read the history, said they went over there, it was storming. They just badly went over because God held back the wall.
Yeah.
And then when they thought going on to their blessing, they were struggling, they were feeling all right.
Yeah.
That song, I'm home my way.
Yeah.
By the time they got straightened up,
yeah,
looked up, something was in their way.
Wow, 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 wow. What's that? Yeah.
Ain't that something?
Yeah.
That's all right.
They prayed all night, wanna jump.
Yeah.
Well, well.
Almost got it, but somebody in your way.
Yeah.
Ain't that something of you? Wanted so bad, so close, but something is in your way.
Yes, sir.
Israelite looked up and saw what was in their way of Stembridge, tell them. The old big city called Jericho.
Yeah.
All right. Yes, sir.
Let me take my time here about 2 minutes and show you about Jericho.
Come on, Pastor.
Jericho was sitting on Brother Charles, the main road. Everybody else, the Philistine and the other Stein, they going up and down Jericho.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The city was on the main road.
Yes, sir.
If they had let the Israelites went through, they could have just went on and got their blessing.
Right. Right, right, right.
But you look at Joshua, the second chapter, the first verse said, the king and the soldiers and all the folks said, we ain't going to let them come through.
Amen, amen.
See now, Jericho wasn't in the way, but what they did, they got in the way.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Amen. Amen.
A lot of people ain't in your way, but they are getting in your way.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Yes. Now, bro, Roy, when I'm driving my car, my truck got me at steady speed, running 70, and you ride along 40, I want to pass you.
Yes, sir. Amen.
But every time I go to pass and you get in my way, you in the way. So they want to go through Jericho, Miss Stembridge, but what Jericho did was they didn't move the city, but they got in the way.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Don't y'all get in the city way. Let them keep on reciting this.
All right.
Don't get it, come bother my children and cry to leave them alone.
Yeah.
Don't, you can't, that song says you can't help them, then get out the way.
Yeah.
Jericho wasn't in the way, but they got in the way.
Uh-huh.
Bro, well, how did they get in the way?
Go ahead, bro.
How they got in the way, the Bible said in that 6th chapter in the first verse, what they did was they shot themselves.
Wow. That's up.
Remember here? Jericho was what we call a fortified city.
Uh-huh. Right.
Fortified means they got a wall all around.
Yeah, yeah.
And now all they do is just keep the gate open, everybody could have went on down.
Uh-huh. Yes, sir.
What this guy do was shut up the city.
Uh-huh.
Then he made a great thing about it. Even when he go home, said nobody could go in.
Well.
Then nobody could come out.
All right.
Because of the children Yes, sir. Something was standing in the way.
Yes, yes, sir.
But all I like what the children of Israel did.
Yes, yes, sir.
Gotta give me a leave in a moment, but I like what he did.
Well, all right.
But man, they didn't turn around and go back.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
They did it during all those 40 years in the wilderness.
Yes, sir.
They kept on trusting in God. Yes, yes. Now, what I tell you, you want a wall to come down.
Yes.
You got to trust.
Yes, sir.
In the Lord.
Yes.
You got to pray to the Lord.
Yes.
Then you got to be still with the Lord.
Yes.
You got to let God give you an
answer. Yes, sir.
And while they were there, God gave them the answer.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Want to help somebody today? Sometime when you pray, we think we know the answer.
All right.
So sometimes we can't wait on the Lord.
Amen.
But you wait.
Yes, sir.
He always, Miss Maddie, going to give you the right answer.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Somebody then took a whole bottle of aspirin. Wherever you call it. BC goodness. Your head feel hurt. You try to answer your own self. But Charlie, you wait on the Lord.
Yeah.
I mean, wait on it.
Yeah.
You ain't got to even stop at the drugs. Bro. You don't need the BC goodness. God's going to give you a high time to
answer.
Look what happened to the Jonathan children of Israel. When they got up there, Miss Stembridge, 40 years in the wilderness.
Yes, sir.
It almost like a little country boy like Charlie Frank growing up in Hancock.
Yeah, right.
All I noticed, I was the farm.
Yeah.
But when I went to New York City, before it was bombed, I saw the Twin Towers.
Uh-huh.
I saw Rockefeller Center.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yes.
Man, I thought I was seeing something big.
All right.
When they saw that Jericho shut up, Brother Maddox.
Uh-huh.
Them soldiers walking around with the spears.
Yes, sir.
They had to wait on God.
Yes.
And God gave them the answer.
Yes, sir.
Let me hear them get through, but God gave them the answer.
Amen.
God told them, march around.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The city one time,
yes,
6 days.
Yes, sir.
Don't you know why they were marching around them soldiers probably laughing at each other? They so scared they about to go out of their mind.
Uh-huh.
They don't know what they're doing.
Uh-huh.
Look at them down there. Like they walk around the hill.
Yes, sir.
One time a day for 6 days.
Yes, sir.
And they were just laughing for them.
Well.
But God had already told them what they
were. Yes, sir.
Not a time to what happened with God's church. Uh-huh.
Yes.
We got a whole lot laughing at us, lick them down every Sunday, worshiping God.
Yeah.
But God already told them, I got a blessing waiting on
me. Yes,
yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And then Mars, they were laughing, Sister Reed. But he said, now on the 7 days, go around 7 times.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You get your preach mode on, blessing them. Start playing the music, y'all start singing and shouting, something's gonna happen.
Yeah. Yeah.
Then y'all make a loud shout and a clap and the wall came down.
Yeah.
It was like we're on the end and got that blessing.
Yes.
Got ready to close now, but it would happen with our blacks, our ancestors, after they were free to meet men of war.
Yes.
But I'm glad the day that God was right there with
yes.
Same thing that got them out of slavery.
Yes.
They were still down on their knees.
Yes.
But they thought there'd be no wall. God was right there.
Yes.
Long and hard for their wall, thought coming down.
Yes.
On the job, wall, thought coming down.
Yes.
Now you can get any kind of job that you want.
Yes.
You can get to the motor anywhere that you want.
Yes.
Because the wall did, thought coming down.
Yes.
Trepidation wall came down.
Yes.
Whether you get on a bus or a train, you can sit anywhere that you want.
Yes.
Because the wall came down. You go in the stove, it's round. We go to shop in the stove that we want. Go upstairs, or downstairs to the store. We go in and found anything that we want. If it don't fit, you can take it off and leave it there in the store. You can do it because the wall had came down. Somebody tell you they ain't God, a good God. They know he is a good God. And the wall will come down. I made up my mind, Reverend Hill ain't worried about me anymore. God's been mighty good. to me. God knows my many goals for me. God broke down many walls for me. By the way, I tell you, I got there one more wall I got to go through. That's called the wall of sin. And I said, Lord, how can I get my sin to get my reward? But I'm glad God said, already they took care of that for you. 2,000 years ago, I said, only God's son down to take care of you. I said, Jesus down to take care of your wall. No sin had a bind, we can't get by the wall. But Jesus, I go down and tear down the wall. They tried to even stop Jesus from getting to sin. They put him on a trial, but Jesus said, I got to go a little bit farther. They took him out there on Calvary Hill. And you know what happened on the hill? He put down my wall. And then we said,
yes, sir.
I can get my reward.
Today.
I told you about the children of Israel, the old crowd, they prayed hard.
Yes.
They prayed hard.
Yes.
And the Lord led them out of slavery. But it said, make my young crowd lazy.
Yes.
Then God said, I got a place for you.
Yes,
sir. Our parents on this Black History Month, they prayed hard for us.
Yeah, they did.
Brother Ward always testifying.
Yes, sir.
How he rode that bike so fast.
Yes, sir.
How he fell.
Yes, sir.
And then get hurt. Give a God, Brother Ward, but I tell you what, the parents in this church,
yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We're praying for you and everybody else.
Yes,
and made it all right, you'll be all right.
Yes,
in Sunday school this morning. And Brother Matt was teaching it so hard, and everybody would come in it so good.
Yes, sir.
You don't just pray for yourself.
Yes, sir.
You don't sin, don't just affect you no more, but it affects everybody else.
Yes, sir.
You don't just affect anybody else. You say anything who is safe.
Okay.
You and everybody else.
Yes,
so what I'm trying to tell you, your crowd, the old Israelite was going on. God bless that young crowd with a better place.
Yes, sir.
Our parents did real good with what they had.
Yes, sir.
But we can do much better if we try to reach our blessings.
Yes,
yes, sir.
Lucinda, Courtney, Taylor, and all the rest of us, Sipho Jr., all of them in college, and all the rest of them.
Yes, sir. There's
going to be some blocks.
Well.
But our job,
yes,
is stay on our knees.
Yes.
And make sure God, when they get to that block,
yes,
don't let nobody
yes
turn around. But help make a way around.
Yes.
And then, as I knew Andrew sang this song, if a block is too high, see the mountain get too high. What do you say? Don't move the mountain. But just give me the strength to climb. Yes. Really, you got me some strength. Let me all stand to our feet today.
Amen.
But what got us to where we are?
Yes.
You don't need no gun, no pistol.
Amen.
You don't need no touch.
Amen.
But what a God is this for?
Yeah.
Every time we want something, other, we throw it much.
Yeah.
We stay in this song, don't let nobody turn us around. So what you trying to get? But sitting there, you riding the truck, but you're on the mail route now. You were tired, you couldn't be there.
Yes, sir.
And a handcuff, and you had this gun, you couldn't be there. And you'd ride the mules with the horses, but not the mail. But look at you now, driving with you in the rain.
Yes, sir.
Making good money. God is good.
Oh, yeah.
Remember, he opened the door for us.
I'm on my way
to